Coming up on Sports Weekly, highlights and interviews from the Aquinas versus Redlands 7-on-7 football passing league. That's next on Sports Weekly. The Aquinas High School football team is keeping it in the family as the Falcons' storied program enters a new season with a familiar face leading the team. Welcome to Sports Weekly. I'm Pep Fernandez. Chris Ibarra had a lot on his plate at Aquinas High School, acting as the athletic director, softball coach, and football coach amongst his duties last year. But when he decided to turn the keys over to the football team, he passed them off to one of his former players and assistant coaches. Let's head out to Redlands High School, where Aquinas played the Terriers in 7-on-7 passing league, and we caught up with Falcons' new head coach, Jordan Brussig, who's been around the Aquinas football team the past 14 years, either as a player himself or as an assistant coach. Brussig takes over an Aquinas team that finished 4-5-1 last season under Ibarra. Brussig said there's a sense of pride when coaching at your alma mater and added that Aquinas is the perfect fit for his first head coaching job. The Falcons will have some talented players this season, which will certainly help Brussig usher in a new era of Aquinas football.
I've been around it since 2001, so I kind of know how we do things here, and I don't necessarily see that there needs to be a big change, but this is my first year, so we'll do some things a little bit different, but the foundation of what we've done in the past is going to stay true.
Is there a little?
I mean, I'm truly blessed that it's an honor to have this job. I've always wanted it, you know, even though it's a small school, people think maybe that pride and tradition doesn't exist there, but it does, and it's something that runs deep for a lot of our families and for my family, and so I'm truly blessed to have it. Coach always preached that you got to be able to enjoy what you're doing, and you know, when I coached with him, he'd always have to tell me, like, look, man, you need to relax a little bit. Remember, this is fun. You know, time to be serious, time to have a good time. And, you know, he taught me how to manage my time a little bit better so that I can come out here and enjoy the time that I have and not make it such a stressful job, because it can be.
It's been a lot of positive energy, a lot of, you know, getting stuff done, a lot of, like, practice, very high tense, very getting stuff done. Like, we've been moving a lot. We've been progressing a lot since the end of last year. We've actually done a lot more, and so far it's really gone good since summer. So hopefully we can progress more and see how it goes.
So I've noticed that he's more on us with what we do and how we do it, and make sure we go 100%.
I hope we can improve on right now, just getting our timing down, our passes, and just our linemen getting the calls right, and just fixing a little tweaks here and there on the line. I think we should be ready to go come week zero.
We can improve everywhere, actually, just in weight room, field, how we play, how aggressive we are, and how we think when we're on the field.
On the Redlands side of the ball, head coach Jim Walker and his staff are feeling more upbeat with the news that longtime assistant coach Mike Mauger continues to improve after having emergency aorta surgery on June 3rd. Mauger has been part of the Terriers program close to three decades, and Walker expects him to continue that this season. While Mauger is in the mend in the hospital, Walker and the Terriers have been busy at work preparing to improve on back-to-back 4-6 seasons, while also settling on a new starting quarterback this season.
Incredible, incredible turnaround for Mike Mauger, a big part of the family here. He's been here, I think, 27 years, and that says something about who he is. But yes, he's been in the hospital for 42 days, but he's in a level of care now where they're trying to get him out, and they're tired of him griping and moaning all the time at the hospital.
Pretty
honoring, huh? Yeah, so they're trying to get rid of him. So, but he's come a long way. He's come a long way, and we're very blessed to have him with us. We'll get down to the nitty gritty during camp when the pads come on, because I think the pads are the great equalizer for all positions. You know, you find out who you have. You know, what kind of warriors you have when the pads come on, and that'll separate, I think, you know, a lot of where we're at. But we're very blessed to have, you know, three guys, a senior, junior, and a sophomore that are all talented kids, and we're excited about that prospect. Been 4-6 2 years in a row. We're a little tired of that. You know, that's not really who we want to be. But we did it with a bunch of young guys. You know, we have 31 seniors this year, and we believe that's going to help us. It's going to give us some experience and some confidence and maturity that we haven't had the last couple of years. So I think experience, hopefully, will be our forte. You know, we return 18 starters off of last year's squad, and sometimes that can be good and bad. You know, you're 4-6, and sometimes you don't want those guys, but we wanted these guys. They're really a talented group, We're big in the right spots. We're fast in the right spots. We've got a really good kicker in Jared Porter. And so, in fact, he's on a trip right now to LSU's recruiting him. So, yeah, we're excited about it. We're excited about the prospects.
And congratulations going out to the Terriers, who captured the championship at the Air Assault 7-on-7 passing tournament at Banning High School this past Saturday. Redlands defeated Paloma Valley High School by a score of 25-13 in the finals. Coming up on Sports Weekly, where will Alexander Madison play his college football? The San Bernardino High School star running back talks college recruiting and what it will take for the Cardinals to make the playoffs this season. That's next on Sports Weekly. Thank you for watching Sports Weekly. You can check out all the segments online anytime by subscribing to the IEMG YouTube channel. You can even leave a comment on the videos, and we may even use it right here on the show. I'm Pep Fernandez. We'll see you next time on Sports Weekly.